Whenever I start a video for, you know, a brand new model, and I show what the model is, I'm always kind of like, you know, talking about it, and then I kind of show the box art, and, you know, go, surprise, and here it is, but then I remember it's, like, right above me on the title screen, and it's like, you know, Airfix is so-and-so, and so-and-so, so it's like, yeah, I'm just fooling myself at this point. What I got today, though, is so cool. I've never done this before, doing a double build. I'm doing a double build of the old Matchbox Vigan, which translates to Thunderbolt, if my Google to Swedish translator was correct. I have three of these. I'm only building two of them. And the fact that I got these other two is nothing short of miracle, good luck, good karma of some kind. I can't think of anything good I would have done to have deserved such a thing, but these were hidden. These were at the Chinook Hobby Store, and I just found out Chinook Hobby Store is gone under new management, and they are changing everything, so these were hidden, and I actually had someone out there today, because I couldn't make it out there, and he found these, like, at the last second, so I'm so excited. I got these things. So I'm going to put these away. I'm going to open up one of them. And the other one I'm sending away. But here it is. I bought this one two and a half years ago, maybe. And Vigan's a pretty cool plane. It's a very pretty plane. It's a Matchbox. La la la. So it is one of my... It is my third favorite kit of all time. Kit manufacturer. My top three kits are Matchbox is third, Tamiya is second, and my favorite is the Revel Monogram 48 scale kits and stuff like that. Those three kits, whenever I see their boxes, I go crazy over. I just love them so much. They're the best. And so this is definitely a lot of fun for me to get to build this guy today. So I've already taken some of the parts have fallen off the sprue. I cut off the fuselage. Whoops, there it goes. I'll pick that up in a minute. That was one of the drop tanks. You get two options for this kit. You get this kind of blue gray one here at the top, and you get this impressive multicolored camouflage. It looks epic, doesn't it? I love it. So I'm building two duplicates of this one here. It's a very, very cool plane. The camouflage, cutting that out has me a bit concerned how to do it. I'm not, you know, terribly worried about it, but I'm a little nervous. But I will figure out a way how to do it, and I'll bite the bullet and just go through it. So here is the fuselage. No cockpit detail. I'm not putting in any cockpit detail. With Matchbox kits, they have very little to no cockpit detail until you get to like the 32nd scale kits. Their 72nd scale kits are basically bare. And I'm going to keep within that tradition. I like to build Matchbox kits like straight out of the box. I've got quite a nice little collection of them. They're in storage right now because I'm cleaning up a whole bunch of stuff, and yeah, I just like to build them straight out of the box, and so that's what I'm going to do with these guys here. So it's pretty big, you know. Take up a bit of room here on my table. I got to make some room for it. Here's the other part of the sprue here. Here's the intakes. You got some nice recessed panel lines, which is always my favorite. Do a panel line wash. Here's the light green sprue. These are the wings and a bunch of the landing gear doors and stuff like that. It is a delta wing, too. I don't know what they call the double delta, though. Maybe that's what they call it. The last sprue here has the rockets, or missiles, I guess they would be. They've got the seats in here, nose, and all this little bits, you know, landing gear. Here's the, I can't remember what they call it, but it's like a buffer. I'll have to explain that. This plane does something incredibly cool that I saw a video of it, and I went, okay, this is a really cool plane. So, weird thing is there's this gap right here, and that's where these drop tanks go. They popped off a long time ago when I opened up the box. There's a chunk right here that's been, like, just cut right off. Right there. What is up with that? There was something else here. And it looks like there's something else here. Because there's no pilot figures, but there's seats, but there's no pilots. That really bugs me, because Matchbox was, like, one of those kit companies that always came with pilots. So, I don't know what happened to them. I'm going to have to dig around and find some. I have to find four pilots for this thing. And they're not included in here, because one of the cool things Matchbox used to do is they used to do this either on the instructions like this or on the side of the box. This was a separate paint diagram. It showed you how to paint all this stuff on here. The decal chart here, and typical Matchbox instructions. They're nice to read. Taking a quick look at the decals here. They look nice, you know, for however old this kit is. They look perfect. You know, they might need some, they might have yellowed a little bit, so I might leave them out in the window for, I don't know, a week or more, maybe. I don't think they'll need that much time, but they look good. And so then the last thing I'll do is I'll use Tester's Decal Bonder, and I'll just spray that on top of those. Unless here's the clear part sprue, and there's a little imperfection on here, but I don't mind it that much. So that's it. I gotta find a box to put all these in, because I'm not gonna use these side boxes. I need an actual something to put them in. Oh, I'll worry about that and get back to you guys later. I'm gonna go start building, but first I have to recharge the battery, because as usual, my battery just runs out. So. Figures and stuff. The last thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give them a wash, just to highlight the details and stuff. Here's the seats. Seats for the Vigan are pretty interesting. They've the cushions in the back are a very very light green. So the green that I use is dark green 2 IJN Imperial Japanese Navy. It's XF70. And what's weird is this color is very close to the color that they use in the Swedish aircraft.
for this particular plane. Pilots, I found this is an Airfix, new tooled Airfix. Whoops. Guess I should have him in the frame. Modern Pilot. This guy came off of the Hind helicopter, the Revel Monogram Matchbox one that I did, and I found two Matchbox pilots. So these guys are going to go into one, and then the other two are going to go into a different one. They're actually quite similar, oddly enough. next up was painting the cockpit and all that. I just painted it this RLM gray, which was pretty close to the colors that they used in the actual aircraft. As far as I could tell, they looked pretty close. And then the back section, I failed to mention this because I did bring it up in the previous part here, is what's so cool about this aircraft. So this is all painted gunmetal. What's really cool about this aircraft is it was designed with a lot of the Swedish aircraft to take off from roads if they needed to. So with this one in particular, they could take off from roads, but they couldn't land. So the guys who were inventing this thing came up with this really cool idea, and I'm sure they used it on other aircraft as well. This goes into the back of the aircraft. You saw me painting this thing. It's this really cool looking cone, and it fits right here in this section of the tail there. And so what they'd do is they would land the plane, and this thing would push into the back, and all the air would blow out the front, causing the plane to slowly push itself in reverse. And it's a really cool process, and I sincerely suggest that you go check it out, because it is, when you see it happen on a real runway, it's just mesmerizing. It's really cool that someone came up with that, and it works too. You know, it's not some concept piece that someone, you know, thought, hey, wouldn't this be cool? And, you know, they put in a prototype. They actually got it to work. That's the really cool thing. One weird thing. I have to show this. This is weird. I bought this kit 2, maybe 3 years ago almost. And there was a whole bunch of these, and actually these are the other ones that I never bought. But look at this, these are the same, these all came from the same thing, they're the same box, but the gray sprue, one's dark gray, one's light gray, as you can see, obviously. And the greens are different. This one's a darker green, and this one's a lighter green. It's kind of weird, you know, it's the same batch of planes, but the innards are different, you know, the plastic sprues are different. It's kind of weird. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to cut these out. Like there. Okay. These are a little weird to glue together because there's nothing. You have to glue this cone onto this cone, and there's no pins or anything, so I was a little worried I wasn't getting it down properly. Another thing to note is the instructions. I had to look this up. The instructions say that this piece goes here, and I never noticed it, but it doesn't even fit. Oh, that's how this fits in here. Okay. Oh, cool. Okay, so there's a lip right here on this ring, and this fits on here, on this lip here. Okay. So the instructions were definitely wrong. Okay. Because I did look it up, and I found out that this is supposed to go here in the back. And then I guess this pushes forward like that to put it in reverse. But like I said, I looked it up online, and I found out that the instructions were wrong, but now I can definitely see they were really wrong, because there's no way that would fit. It's way too narrow. So yeah, I'm gonna get building this, and then what I'm gonna do is put the pilots in the chairs and then set them inside here. So I'm gonna quit yapping and
Together with all the putty, and so this will take a while to dry, but you know, it'll be like forever. This stuff dries pretty quick, thankfully. Yeah, and then I'm going to sand that all down and put the intakes in here. Now the funny thing is these intakes, they actually don't fit. There's little pegs right here on this one. There, little pegs. They don't fit. They don't match up. So it's simple enough. You just cut them off, and away you go. And the figures, I'll go paint it up and glue it in place. I just have to give them a wash, and they'll fit in here, like so. About like that. So. That's pretty exciting. Onto the sanding and try not to damage anything else. Alright, so here's just updating everything. This is the vegan so far. I've almost finished sanding. I just have to do this back part here. I was working on this last night and I just got tired and I put it aside. I just wanted to go to bed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to finish sanding it. There's quite a bit of unevenness with this model, and that's a couple of things. One is lack of injector pins in some areas, but the other thing is too, is they put the halves together, and this bottom part here was like gone. It didn't. Let me just adjust this a little better. I don't know. Hopefully. So like, yeah, this you had to put in here, and the structure, gluing it, wasn't that strong, so it didn't glue too evenly. But I'm getting there. You can see this one's a little bit worse off in a few areas, but I've got it down. It's nice and smooth. And the next step. Oh, one funny thing. Actually, I should mention that what happened. Is I was sanding down this seam right here with, the sandpaper. I'm going like this, and I'm looking at it, and there's all these little, little balls of plastic. And I took a close look at it, and I realized what I was doing is I was sanding it so fast, and the plastic is so dry and so old. Not so old, but old enough that it was melting the plastic. Oops. So I had to stop and move on to the other model and sand it down and then kind of rotate. But I'm actually quite impressed with this. Next step after this is to scribe in all the all the areas that I've kind of filled in. So that'll be the next step. And then after that, you will see I will add on the wings. The wings fit really, really well. They just kind of, you know, way kind of snap in. I got to look at some technical drawings, because the wings, they kind of fit, like they look like they're supposed to be straight, but on the model, let me try and get this on the camera. They're you can see that they're kind of pointed down, so they should be like this, but they fit like this. So I'm gonna have to check in on that. And probably all I'll do, if they are supposed to be straight, which I'm betting they are, but you never know, I'll just have to sand down this beam right here until it's more flush. So that's just the little update on what's going on. I gotta finish sanding it, and more and more and more and more. It sucks. I hate it. I hate sanding, but it's fun. It's fun getting to work on these kits. They're, you know, again, they're Matchbox, so they're worth it. So, yeah. Let's get sanding down the rest. So I've had quite enough of sanding everything down. I'm so tired of sanding. Here it is, anyways. I glued on the front wings here, and of course the back. The fit for the back wasn't too good, so what I did is I've done something here on this one. I've never done this before. I stuffed some styrene in here, very, very thin white strip. I did that in a couple other spaces. On this one here, too. Yeah, worked out pretty well, I think. And very beautiful shape to this aircraft. It looks a lot like a Eurofighter in a lot of ways, doesn't it? So the next step is what I'm going to do, I think, is I'm going to mask off the canopy bits here, glue them on, and I'm going to prime the whole model Tamiya primer, because I don't trust this plastic at all for airbrushing acrylics. I don't think acrylics had come on the scene yet when these were around. It was mostly done with enamel and stuff like that, but yeah, I'm just so sick and tired of cleaning and sanding. I hate it. It's part of the game, but it's my least favorite part. That's just me personally. There's other guys out there who are much, much, much more talented at it. Make it look far too easy for me. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to cover up the cockpit section. I'm not going to worry about the engines. I'm just going to spray them all gray, and I'll repaint these later, I think. They shouldn't be too much work to, it'll be more work, I think, to cover them up. But yeah, that's it. I'm just tired. It's hot here. Very, very hot, humid day, and I've had enough of it. Hope it cools down here soon, but it's a perfect time to paint. So let's go and let's do that. It's looking